Hello, in this video I'm going to explain the software development lifecycle in 5 minutes. So what is the software development lifecycle? If you want to develop a software like Microsoft Windows or even a smaller software solution, then the software development goes through various stages and the goal is to develop the software very fast at the very lowest cost. So it goes to various stages to achieve this goal and to maintain the software long term. The first stage is the so-called requirements analysis. In that stage, we want to find out what should be developed. Because in this phase, the software developer or the project manager will talk to the client and will find out what the solution is all about. For this, they will ask different questions to the client. For example, if a contact form should be developed for the solution, then they could ask different questions like how should the button look like, how should the entries look like, which all fields should be in this contact form, like phone number, email address, and so on. And they will continue asking these questions till they fully understand the requirement. And for each module, like the contact form or the user portal or any other part of the solution, they will ask these questions and find out what the client actually wants. That is the so-called requirements phase. The next phase is called the planning phase. Here the project manager and the team members like the software developers will discuss how to develop the software and make a plan for it. In this stage, usually also the cost for the solution is evaluated. They will plan who will do what in the development phase, which comes later. Usually the team will also discuss what kind of risks could be faced during development. For example, there could be parts of the development where even the development team is not sure how long it will take, or maybe it will longer than it is expected. So this risk they will communicate between the team and also will communicate these issues with the client. After that, the design phase will start. With the design, they mean not the design of the front end, but the architectural design of the software. For example, how should the database look like? How should the database be developed so that it can be maintained long term, that new modules can be added to the software? Basically, the main goal should be how can the software develop so that it is future proof and that it remains scalable even if more users are going to use it. In a lot of software projects, this is usually an issue because they didn't plan that what happens in case the software gets bigger, new modules get developed, and at that stage usually they will start developing it from scratch. But if the proper architectural design is created in the beginning, then it is possible to also add on software modules to this software. Next, we come to the development phase. Here the actual coding is happening. So the software developers will agree on tasks they will do. They will divide them amongst each other and they will start coding. This might be the biggest part of the project because several team members, programmers might be involved in this, and it might take several months with several team members to develop the actual software. But it is still important to remember the previous phases, like the requirements phase and the planning phase and the design phase, which are very crucial so that this development part is really well done. When the coding, the development is finished, then it goes in the testing phase. In this testing phase, there will be software testers which will manually test the software and also use automation software to test the software, whether it is doing what it's supposed to do. And if everything is okay, they will also give it to the client and let them check. And the client will, of course, only do simple checks, but they can check whether everything is working, whether the forms are working, and so on. When everything is tested and everything is fine, then it goes in the deployment stage, because usually the software is developed on the server of the development company, for example, a software company or an IT company, and now it needs to be transferred to the client's server. For that, there's a team which will deploy those softwares to the live, which is on the client side, which means then at that point of time, every user can actually use it. But the problem is usually that the deployment side is different from the development side. The configuration might be different. The processors used might be different. So there could be issues faced. So there needs to be a deployment phase where it is properly handed over to the client. And then it becomes live and everyone uses it. After that, it goes into the maintenance phase. Software usually needs to be updated from time to time. There could be also bugs which appear, which are then communicated to the development team. They will rectify those issues. And this is an ongoing process, because if the software is used for a long time, then usually more and more maintenance issues comes and it needs to be solved. So that is the complete software development lifecycle. It's called a lifecycle because, again, after the maintenance phase, the client might come and say, I again want some software to be developed. At that point of time, this whole process starts again. The requirements are analyzed, then it's again planned, this design is adjusted, and it goes into the development. And this is a cycle which continues on and on, especially in large software projects which need to be developed, where modules need to be developed from time to time. I hope this video was helpful to understand what the software development lifecycle is. We build software development teams in India. In case you have any requirements, shoot us an email to info@softwaredeveloperindia.com and we can build you a team which builds software. What is your opinion about this software development lifecycle? Do you handle it differently? What is your experience? Would like to love to hear from you in the comment section below. And kindly subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much.